The gaze menu is a fully gaze controllable user interface that gives the user the ability to freely navigate the menu options, open and close apps, and access some external communication applications. We'll start by taking a look at the menu. Here we have all the apps contained within Magikot FX. Here they're broken down into levels. See the separate video on levels for more information on this. Here we have the store and the settings. At the moment, I'm set as click mode as opposed to dwell mode, which means that I can freely gaze around the screen without selecting anything. It's first necessary to make a couple of settings adjustments just to make sure they're right for you. So first things first, we need to go back to the home screen and into the config section so we can make sure we have the correct switch input settings. To do this, we're going to head up to settings. We're going to press spacebar. And then over to the right, exit to home. This takes us back to the familiar home screen. From here, we're going to access the side menu and the config section. Here, I've got my switch activation key option set as space and return, which means that when I gaze around while in click mode in gaze menu, I will need to press either space or return in order to make a selection. We'll save settings and we'll head back to the gaze menu. So while in the All Apps section, we can browse through the various apps. We can now dwell on an app icon and press either space or return. And that's going to immediately run the game. We can exit the app in a normal way. We can browse through pages. And we can jump to the level section and access any apps that are contained within each level. Store is still under construction. We're about to launch that. So watch this space, that'll be available soon. Let's head over to settings. So here is where we choose which gaze mode we'd like to use. So here I have it set to click mode. I can change it to dwell mode just by dwelling on the dwell mode button and pressing space. And you'll see we have a default dwell time of 1.75 seconds. And we can change that. We can increase it, or we can decrease it. For now, I'm going to keep it in click mode. As you can see, the dwell options then disappear. Over here, we have the ability to add snap core or communicator to the menu simply by selecting them, and now they're accessible in the main menu. And obviously the exit to home button, which gets us back to the main home screen.